In Europe, over 2 million people are affected by ulcerative colitis or Crohn's disease, conditions that are characterized by an inflammation of the bowel. They occur when cells from our immune system become activated and react against contents of the intestine, leaving the patients with fatigue, abdominal pain and severe diarrhea, blood in stools, or even with life-threatening complications such as bowel perforation, bleeding, and in long-standing disease, an increased risk of cancer. Alarmingly, the incidence of IBDs is increasing. It is now one of the most common immune-mediated diseases in young adults. The main therapeutic options are conventional drugs or biological therapy. Both inhibit immune cells, but increase, as a side effect, the risk of infections. Moreover, they are only effective for limited subsets of patients. Recent clinical studies testing a new class of drugs have pointed out two potential targets inside immune cells, JAK1 and JAK3. These proteins are needed for immune cell activation. Thus, without them, the inflammation will be hampered. Unfortunately, these drugs have a systemic distribution, are not specific, and present adverse effects. That's why scientists and companies all over Europe have joined forces to fix this unmet clinical need in a research project called New Deal. They will target JAK1 and JAK3 in a more specific way, using small pieces of genetic material called siRNAs. These molecules will interfere with the cellular production of JAK1 and JAK3 by binding exclusively the molecules that contain their genetic instructions and impeding the synthesis of these two proteins. Without them, the activation of the cells is hindered and the inflammation decreases. But to make it into these cells is a challenge. To reach the bowel, the siRNAs will be incorporated into microcapsules, and inside them, lipid nanoparticles will guarantee their stability and allow them to enter the cells. This formulation will allow a local distribution, diminishing possible side effects. Scientists will test this strategy in mouse models of the disease to be able to provide the regulatory agencies a solid preclinical proof of concept that would open the door to start human clinical trials and test the real capabilities of this therapy in the future. The way from the laboratory research to the bedside requires around 10 years. New Deal aims to be the first step towards it. If you want to follow the progress of this project, please subscribe to our newsletter.